guys, Noah from SearchBug here. I'm going to demonstrate our new phone number and name append for bulk or batch services. You can upload up to 10,000 records here. 10,000 names, addresses, or just addresses to get names and phone numbers. If you want to know how much it's going to be, it doesn't matter how big the file is, upload up to 10,000. If we find 3,000 of those 10,000, for example, it's still going to cost $462. If we find 5,000 of the 10,000, it's $712. It doesn't matter how many you upload up to 10,000, there's no charge if no name or phone is found. So the best way to start is to just start with your list, first name, last name, address. Put the suite in with the address if you have suites, because you'll see when we upload it with a separate suite row, there's no way to define the suite number. So make sure the complete address is in the address column. We're going to save this as a tab delimited text file. So save as, you see one of the selections is tab delimited. Go ahead and save it as tab delimited. Click save. Yes. Yes. And then we're done. We're going to click choose file. We're going to see our tab delimited text file there. Open it. And then when you click continue, it's going to process that and pull in your rows. Okay, so after you upload the file, and now I'm not sure of the first name, and I don't want to use it because I might want to get more results at this address here. So if I only use the name and the address, it's only going to give me the phone number found for that name and address, but I want other names and phone numbers at that address. So I'm going to say do not use the name part, just use the address. Don't use the suite because there is no suite, it has to be included. And you can't mix business names and first names and last names in the same file. Then you're going to tell it's a city, state, and zip, and then we're going to continue to the next step. Now it's going to tell us that we the maximum cost for the 7 records, because we have a $5 minimum, is $5. That's the maximum cost. But obviously you're going to upload more than 7 records if you use this system. Now, if I uploaded a lot more, there would be another option besides process now. It would say process later, which would be a good option if you had a lot of records. So if I click process my data now, it's going to ask me to log in here. And I'll go ahead and do that. Gonna be right back. Now you can see it says processing 7 records, 0 are done. 7 more to go. And we're gonna wait for that to finish. You'll also notice that while it's processing, I didn't have to enter my credit card because I have a prepaid balance, which is shown up at the top here. So it's just gonna deduct my fee from my account balance. Okay, now once it's complete, it shows it's all done. It tells me the number of hits, the hit ratio, and that it took less than a minute to complete. If I want to download the results, I click on down the results, or I can optionally right click and use save as. So I'm just going to save them in a temporary directory. It's basically your file name with a number after it, which includes some information like the date. And once I save this, I'll show you what it looks like. Okay, because I did it in a text delimited format, it's going to give me the file back in a text delimited format. And then when I try and open it up in Excel, it's going to say, all right, this is a delimited file. Tell me what it is. You would just open it like this and you would see the information. You just click next and the delimiters will automatically be placed in the tab column. So when you click next, it'll just say, these are the columns, then click finish. And then your file will open like so. And you'll see it has name 1, name 2, name 3, phone name 1, phone 1, name 2, phone 2, etc. Telling you which fields we found which information on. And of course you can open your file up like that and then you see all your original information. And that's it. Now if you can't find your report, you can always click on My Account here and then Reports. And then they'll be down here. So you would just click your search type, your reports down in the bottom there, and you can open it up here.